We are following this breaking news from overnight. Serious stuff. Protests turned violent in Minnesota following the death of an African-American man in police custody. Channel 3's Caitlin Francis has the latest for us now. Kate?
Eric, those protests in Minneapolis resulted in fires, including to the police department's third precinct, as well as looting across the city. A state of emergency has been declared there. Similar protests taking place across the country as well, including Columbus, Denver, and New York. Protesters took to the streets chanting, "I can't breathe," as many rallied peacefully and marched downtown. 46-year-old George Floyd died Monday after being detained by Minneapolis police on suspicion of passing a phony $20 bill. The four officers involved in Floyd's death were fired, including the officer seen in a viral video kneeling on Floyd's neck until he lost consciousness. Those officers may face criminal charges and are now the subject of several investigations, including by the FBI and Justice Department. But people are calling for more immediate action. The president taking to Twitter last night in reaction to the violence after, as I mentioned, that Minneapolis third precinct was set on fire and looting ensued. The president says, quote, "I can't stand back to watch this happen to a great American city, Minneapolis. A total lack of leadership. Either the very weak radical left mayor Jacob Frey get his act together and bring the city under control, or I will send in the National Guard and get the job done right."
I am pleading with individuals to remain calm and to let us conduct this investigation.
Now, the National Guard was called in by the governor of the state. Police did use tear gas and rubber bullets on protesters when these demonstrations turned violent. It's all compared to rock throwing on Wednesday night. Now, I do want to mention the tweet by the president was flagged by Twitter for violating rules about glorifying violence. However, Twitter determined it may be in the public's interest for that tweet to remain accessible. We'll continue to follow these developments throughout the morning. I'm Caitlin Francis, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.